Welcome to my channel. Today I've got another nail art video for you. That's not my regular nail art of painting on the nails, but actually an acrylic look. We're going to get very close up to the nails in a moment, but I figured I'd just do the introduction like this, because face-to-face talk just seems a little bit more polite and fun than just, you know, me talking with a voiceover while you just see nails at a standstill, and that's it. A little while back I did a video on the entire basics of how I, as an amateur, do my acrylic nails, like prepping, priming, and just building the nail. I'll link that video somewhere up here. But I also promised I do a video specifically about how I do a French tip and a fade in nails. So I did that on these two nails specifically for the purpose of this video. Just to tell you how I do that, how I do those particular looks. We're gonna get close up in a moment. I just wanted to tell you beforehand, keep in mind, like a bit of a disclaimer really, keep in mind, I'm a professional makeup artist. I'm not a professional nail tech. I just do this all myself because I enjoy doing my own nails, but you know, just don't take what I say as a complete fact. Because it's not, it's just my way of doing stuff that might not be the official way of doing stuff. Just keep that in mind. Other than that, let's get started. Now, I'm starting off with the filing already done, as in I've removed all product. This nail needs a refill, the other one, for example, needs to be completely rebuilt, but on both nails we're just going to start off with a basic clear layer. So just a very, very thin clear layer, so when I want to file off this design, I can just file down to the clear acrylic rather than to have to remove the entirety of the nail. It saves a little bit of time, it's just a little bit easier, and also prevents staining of the natural nail, because there's always a layer of clear between that and the color. Then I'm going to go on for the French tip nail with a bead of nude acrylic. And I'm really making sure first to get it very nice and thin and smooth at the edges near the cuticle. Both because it also prevents lifting if your cuticle area is nice and thin. But also it just looks a lot nicer than if you had just have this random, really thick bit of acrylic suddenly starting out of nowhere. So yeah, just first work on that while the acrylic bead is still very thin. And then I start pulling it forward carefully. And basically I always try to form as much as the edge of the, well, the smile line. It's called a smile line, it actually has a name. I always try to form it as much as I can with the brush because, you know, the more you do with the brush, then the less you have to file. It's just a lot easier in my opinion. So yeah, just carefully do that. Really make sure, of course, to not get it on my fingers. And then we're left with this. So that can dry for a little bit before we can file the edge there. And while it's filing, I'm going to show you the fade. I'm going to start off again by basically the same thing. A nude bead, really get it nice and thin around the cuticles. And then I'm just going to blend it forward this time while the entire bead is still wet. And we don't need to wait for it to dry on this nail because, you know, we're going to do a fade. So we don't need to file anything because we don't actually want harsh lines here. I don't really have a lot of colors, admittedly, in acrylic. I have a lot of nail polish, so I'm not allowed by myself to buy a lot more acrylic colors because I really need to use my nail polishes up first. I went for glittery blue because I really didn't have much of a different color to go for. I go back from blue to nude to blue to nude just until it's as smooth as I can get it in really thin layers, of course. And then I add a more glittery blue over top of it to make it even more of an ombre. The specific names of the colors I'm using, by the way, I'll just put below the video. Of course, for the nude shade, you know, you may want to pick one that actually suits your skin color. But yeah, that's obvious. And then we have this. By then, it's time to go file the smile line. And always press against the edge of the smile line. Never press down on the tip, because at this point the tip is still very, very thin and it might break if you're too rough with it. Be very careful with that. And also I always like to keep the tip a little bit like the tip of the smile line. The edge of the smile line. I try to keep that a little bit thicker than necessary, just because if I now go over it with the color for the tip itself, I can still file it down and get a nice crisp line without risking making the nail too thin there. So it's just a bit of a fail-safe really. And then of course fill in the tip. I'm keeping that thin too because I'm still going to clear cap it. There's another thing, by the way, you got to keep in mind. Clear acrylic is usually made for strength. Colored acrylics are usually made for color. So you really do want to like build up the nail with the clear, like get the shape of the nail with the clear acrylic and not with the colored acrylic. With the exception of the nude shade, that is actually a strength powder, but depending on the brand you use, you're going to have to check that for yourself. And also the clear acrylic is just going to make sure that you don't file into the color and file into the glitter and thereby ruin their looks. It just protects the entire thing. And because the nude shade is a building powder, I don't have to clear cap that, so I'm really focusing clear on the tip here. And at that point we already have a decently shaped set of nails. I'm just going to file really quickly off camera because I'm pretty sure we already showed it in the last acrylics video. So yeah, just fast forward to filed nails. And then it's just time for top coat. I'm using a gel top coat and I love when adding top coat, how the glitter just comes to life. I just love glitter. But yeah, anyway, you can use a normal top coat too, but it's usually for me when I go for full on acrylic look, I usually go for gel top coat because the acrylic can last for ages and gel top coat can too, whereas normal top coat will usually wear down quicker. But yeah, if you for some reason don't have gel top coat or don't want to use gel top coat, a normal top coat will work as well. And then we're already done with both the designs. And that leaves us at the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And by the way, I am actually planning on doing some more acrylic tutorials in the near future. I don't know when this is going to be online. But I do have a week of work in May. I was actually planning on going on vacation, but we're probably just going to be stuck at home still then. But yeah, just to make a bad thing into a good thing, I can use the time to film some more extra videos that take me too much time to do on regular working weeks, like acrylic videos. So yeah, that's what I'm planning on doing. Anyway, if you want to see all that and also all my other videos that I'm planning on filming, mostly makeup tutorials really, you can always subscribe to my channel. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!